I remember one of the nights I really prayed, and like God was shaking me. Aria, be ready to leave everything, to leave music, to leave all what was part of your life, and be ready to live in this place. That's how it started. So we are in the biblical garden of Yad HaShmona. Yad HaShmona is the only village of Jewish messianic in Israel. And it's really a fruit of many dreams of many people. And it all started when a group from Finland, Finnish people, they were volunteers in the neighbor kibbutz. And they felt very strong. They passed some hard thing in Finland concerning Jewish people. And the hard thing was that there were 7 Jews. Originally, there were actually 8 that were given to the Nazis and ended in Auschwitz. It was in Finland. And they were really to try to find a way to reconcile it, to do something, to memorize this group of Jews. And that's how they came at the end to the Prime Minister of Israel, Golda Meir. They got permission to start a kibbutz of non-Jewish people. It is a unique, the first one and the last one in Israel. They named it Yad HaShmona, Memory of the 8. Look now how God's ways work. They really got a mountain in 1974. 2 years later, I was here with my 2 brothers. How I arrived here? I was a youth leader of the believers' children in those days. We speak about 1976. Very, very few believers were here. So what happened actually, we looked for a place to make a youth camp. And somebody recommended this hill. There was nothing, almost nothing here. But this somebody was a pastor in Jerusalem. And he told us, look, I have a group of Finnish people that come to our assembly every Shabbat. They live in a place not far from Jerusalem. Maybe you can make the youth camp there. So we arrived here and we were running a youth camp here. At the end of the camp, the Finnish people, actually 6 people, that's all what was Yad HaShmona then, really with tears in their eyes, they say that this is our dream, that Israelis will live here and run a place and teach the Bible here, and it will be a center for teaching Bible. And they looked on us, would you consider about staying here and living here and develop this place? And I asked them, what can I work here? And they asked me what I do. I said, I play on contrabass. Now, they didn't really understand. But slowly, they understood that it's a big violin. And they said, it's a pallion. Pallion is a very big wood, a lot of wood, right? A lot of wood. I said, yes, yeah, there is a lot of wood, right? So you will be the head of the carpentry. That's how I found myself the head of the carpentry for 25 years, right? And really, I had to study from beginning, but I had a great privilege that father of my wife, which was well-known carpenter, God led him to be here 3 years and teach me. From the time that I arrived to Yad HaShmona already, immediately I wanted to know every plant, every tree, every bird, everything on this mountain. You know, I was a city man, and for me to come to this hill, it was really God's creation. So I really felt very strong need to know, to study. And of course, with this, I was involved very deep in the land and the Bible. From beginning, we had a lot of volunteers here. Every week, I took 10 of them to a Bible tour. So for around 20 years, that's when I was just guiding them. I was guiding all the mountains of Sinai, the desert of Jordan, I mean, all over. And when I was 50, exactly 17 years ago, I really felt very strong that this is going to be my main thing. And this was because of some believers that met me, that I guided them. They felt that I have to finish with carpentry and go to be a Bible teacher with the guiding. It was very hard for me, I tell you, because I was always a man that worked with hands. If it's playing, if it's conducting, if it's carpentry, and suddenly not to do anything. That's what I said. I mean, at the end of the day, what I will say, what I did. There's no chair, there's no table. I mean, what I did, how I spent my time. It was very complicated for me. And I really had to study, really, really had to study that God is using us different way. So more and more. At the beginning, the first 7 years, I was one-third a carpenter, one-third musician, one-third a tour guide, and another third, find it, I was involved very much in the military service. I was officer and I did a lot of military service. And we had a lot of wars between them. It was quite hard, but to make the switch all the time from one job to another, to the third, to the fourth, many times on the same day when it happened. And praise the Lord, more and more believers came to me. Arye, you have to concentrate only on Bible and the land of the Bible, I mean teachings. And this happened around 8 years ago. This was really, it was a transit when I just started doing only this. It was hard for me to quit from the carpentry, very hard. But praise the Lord, more and more, I found that this is the call for my life. Sharing the Bible, the land of the Bible, which I studied it all my life. And I'm from the generation that we covered the land like Abraham with our legs, right? No cars, with our legs, every valley, every tree. And I know how much it meant to me to know the land, in this beautiful land that we have, beautiful land. And there share about how God worked with the hearts of people and brought it step by step. I think it's so beautiful. God is talking through the land, really talking through every stone here, every bird is talking. And this is in my heart, to continue to lead people back to the Word, back to the Bible, and back to the land that He chose to appear to us. I have two groups every month, so 24 groups a year, plus other groups that I guide Israeli believers. So it's around 30 groups a year, which doesn't give you free time, right? So I thought maybe when I would be 70 years old, I will reduce a little bit the guiding and take more time for really writing and teaching. But I know, because I feel full of energy to continue another 15 years, right? Really, I don't feel in any way that, I'm 70. I feel, actually, when I started this, it really brings you back to feel young man. Yeah, really. And this is the miracle that God is doing in our life, right? He's producing us again and again and again. I'm here now 33 years, and so glad to see that everything around us fulfilled. Yeah.